He never slumbers. Why? Because he wants to make sure that the kingdom of God, his kingdom, his authority, his ownership, his everything, his creations is back to him. So he wakes up one day and he says, let me go down there by myself and do what? And win man back to me. Because I've sent prophets, I've sent apostles, but nothing works. So he comes. But what did we do to him? If we kill God, who are you not to be killed? What does it feel?
Amen.
My encouragement to us is, it is work. It is work. And it is work. It is never easy. But also many a times we might look unto the number and say we have thousands and thousands who have given themselves their life to Jesus Christ. But you see, Jesus Christ is saying, go and preach the gospel. Go and make disciples. We are not just preaching the gospel, but we are making disciples. Because at the end of it, we must have someone who understands what the kingdom of God is all about and who is God in their lives, and not just knowing about God. So, will we sit down? In our well-built and made sanctuaries with our wonderful, designed clothes, waiting for them to come. Jesus is saying, go where? As I finish, my time is over. Have you ever read the story about Isaiah? Isaiah was told what? Remove your sandals and sandals. And he walked for how many years? 3 good years naked. 3 good years naked, barefoot, for the glory of God to be experienced now. So, brethren, I did not just come from Nairobi, leave my work, my family, and I come to Mombasa just to waste time. And I did not just come to talk to people to turn from their religion to Christianity. I came here for the gospel, and I came here to make a disciple. And that disciple I must make. And that is my call to each and every one of us. Because it is hard. It is never easy. It calls for sacrifice. But now this is the hard time. It is the hard work. You must give back, but in pain. They will chase you. You will run. You will call for help. Remember the question when you see a snake? You will call for help. You might kill the enemy, but sometimes or many a times the enemy always will you to him by tricking you. When you talk to someone and they say, I'm saved, mama, I'm saved, I know who Christ is. And deep in their heart, they know, they don't know who Christ is. That is the work of the enemy. When you talk to someone and they look at you and they say, you Christian, you're just wasting your time. And someone will come and say, just pray for me. It is the work of the enemy. Why? Because he knows this is my person. You cannot, and you have no authority over this person. If he could test Jesus, tempt him. Who are you? Who are you not to be tempted by him? And he tells Jesus, because he knows that he is the owner, so he tells Jesus, jump from here so that every other thing shall be yours. You see that? That is mine, but it will be yours. But Jesus takes him where? Back to the word of God. As we are going out there, brethren, let us have in mind that the ground that we are stepping into, there is an owner, someone who owns it, that we give that ownership to. But also put in back in your mind the rightful owner of that ground. So if you go with his power and his authority, then you shall be able to win over that space. Lastly,
Amen.
Fast
Amen.
God bless you, and I pray that God will use us. Have a blessed time.